Welcome to Bani Hashim Brigade. Today we will expose severely the lies and ignorance of the apostate prophet again. Deceivers like apostate prophet and others claim that the night journey of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, from Mecca to Jerusalem, which are 1500 kilometers apart, and then into the heavens is fake. And out of illiteracy, said that the white winged horse animal, whose name is Burraq, on which Prophet traveled, and all that incident is just a fairy tale. Well, they are blatant liars and experienced deceivers. To be clear, the night journey of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, throughout the heavens is absolutely real and physical, and there are absolute proofs for it that nobody can deny. And you will be astonished to see that deceiver apostate hid such truths from you people and tried to misguide you people. Take a look at these stunning hadiths. I will be explaining you the hadiths in short so that it would be easy for you to understand. Otherwise, if I will tell you each and everything, the video would turn out to be an hour long. When Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, came back from the night journey from the heaven, he went to Aman, who was the servant of Prophet Muhammad's mother Amina. After listening the incident of night journey from the Prophet, she asked him not to tell the incident to the people of Mecca because they would not believe him and they may harm him. The Prophet replied that it's my responsibility to tell it to the people, and whatever may be the response of the people, God was responsible for the outcome. So after the Fajr prayer in the early morning, Prophet Muhammad was sitting in the morning thinking about how to tell people about the incident. Abu Jahl, one of the greatest enemies of Islam, saw the Prophet. He came to the Prophet and asked, "O Muhammad, has anything happened to you?" The Prophet replied, "Yes, I went to Jerusalem last night and came back." Listening this, Abu Jahl amused and asked the Prophet to repeat the same statement in front of the people, and he went to gather the people. He gathered as many people as he could and asked them to listen to what Prophet has to say. The Prophet repeated the same sentence that, "Last night I went to Jerusalem and came back and told them about his journey to the heavens." The people laughed and mocked a lot. Then they told the Prophet that if you have really been to Jerusalem, then tell us about the map of Baitul Muqaddas. The Prophet then started explaining them whatever he saw there, but he did not remember much about it. At that instant, Allah showed Baitul Muqaddas to the Prophet in front of his eyes, and then he started explaining the details of the Baitul Muqaddas brick by brick. Among the people of Mecca were some who had already been to Jerusalem and they agreed with the description. Mutam bin Uddi was one of who had been to Jerusalem earlier. So once the disbelievers started to get their answers, they changed their question and asked Prophet to explain if he had seen any caravans during his journey. The Prophet then explained them about three caravans of Quraysh who were returning back to Mecca, giving details about each one of them, and told them about three incidents also that had occurred with him while returning from the Jerusalem to Mecca. While returning back from Jerusalem to Mecca, when Prophet came at a place called Ruha, he saw a caravan. People of this caravan were searching for their missing camel. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was feeling thirsty. So when he reached this place, he saw a water bottle and he drank water from it. When he was about to continue the journey, he saw the man who was searching for missing camel coming back. Prophet Muhammad greeted him. Some of the people in the caravan recognized Prophet's voice and said, "It sounds like Muhammad's voice." When the Prophet reached Zilfajja, he saw second caravan. He saw two friends riding same camel. When Burraq passed, their camel got scared and ran away. Both friends fell from it and one of them broke his hand. He saw third caravan at a place called Dalailun He saw a brown camel in front of it, having two sacks over it, one with white lines and other with black lines. The people of Mecca asked the Prophet, "When will those caravans return?" The Prophet said that the first caravan will reach on sunrise tomorrow, the second in the afternoon, and the third will reach just before sunset. Now when the people knew about the time of arrival of the caravans, two groups of people of Mecca went to high mountains and began waiting for the sunrise. One group was of disbelievers of Mecca who wanted to see Prophet Muhammad's saying going wrong, while the other group was of Muslims who were sure that whatever their Prophet said will come true. Muslims were looking for the caravan while the disbelievers were waiting for the sunrise. The moment sun showed its light, a disbeliever said in a loud voice, "By God, sun has raised." And he did not even finish. That Muslim said in even louder voice, "See there, caravan has arrived." Seeing this, the disbeliever said, "We don't believe. It's magic." Same thing happened with the second caravan. However, the third caravan arrived a bit late. Sun was about to set and there were no signs of the caravan. So the Prophet prayed to Allah and Allah stopped the sun from setting. Another miracle happened in front of the people of Mecca. The disbelievers became very uncomfortable and said, "This is plain magic. The sun is not setting from such a long time." And then an hour later, the third caravan arrived too, and then the sun set. Before each caravan entered the city, the people of Mecca reached and asked them about the incidents Prophet told to them, and all of them accepted that it was true. But the disbelievers still did not believe it. There is a lot more detail in the hadith books with names of people and what more happened. We have enumerated just the main incidents. If we will tell everything in detail, the video will turn out to be too long. You can download the book Hujjatul Aalamin fi Mojizaate Sayyidil Mursaleen yourself and read everything. The Urdu translation is available with me and on the internet too. In it, read the hadiths from page number 550 up to 600. You can search for the English translation of those books too. I don't know whether they are available on the internet or not. All these things are mentioned in the chapter of Miraj. Also, you can download and see for one hadith in Kitab Ash Shifa at page number 321. So how can we deny the incident of Prophet's night journey after such proofs given by him? And wait, we have another staggering proof of the incident in which the Prophet didn't give the proof himself, but unknown people confirmed the Prophet's night journey. Sit tight and listen to this. This has been mentioned in Tafseer Ibn Kathir, taken from the book Dalailun Nabuwwah, which literally translates to proof of prophethood, written by Imam Bayhaqi. Let's have a look there. When Abu Sufyan and his men were brought in front of the Caesar Heraclius, Heraclius asked him about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So Abu Sufyan was a great enemy of Prophet until then, but he did not lie in front of the Caesar Heraclius, because he knew his men were listening, and if he would be caught, Heraclius will never believe him again. So he played a trick and answered in this way, "O king, shall I not tell you of something from which you will know that he is lying?" The king said, "What is it?" Then Abu Sufyan said, "He claims that he went out of our land, the land of Al-Haram, in one night and came to your sanctuary in Jerusalem, then came back to us the same night before morning came." The patriarch of Jerusalem was standing there next to the Caesar. The patriarch of Jerusalem said, "I know that night." Caesar looked at him and said, "How do you know about this?" He said, "I never used to sleep at night until I closed the doors of the sanctuary. On that night, I closed all the doors except for one, which I could not manage to close." I asked my workers and others who were with me to help me deal with it, but we could not move it. It was like trying to move a mountain. So I called the carpenters, and they looked at it and said, the lintel and some part of the structure has fallen onto it. We cannot move it until morning, when we will be able to see what the problem is. So I went back and left those two doors open. The next morning, I went back and saw that the stone at the corner of the sanctuary had a hole in it, and there were traces of an animal having been tethered there. I said to my companions, this door has not been closed last night except for a prophet who prayed last night in our sanctuary. The patriarch said that the next morning I tried to close the door and it closed very easily. Then I knew the reason why door wasn't closing last night. In ancient religious books, I had read that a prophet will travel to skies from Baitul Muqaddas one night. So I called my servants and told them the reason. And this hadith has reached the status of being mutawatir. Look at that. Narrated from so many different companions of the prophet through different chains. So many in just one book. Imagine what from other scholarly sources. Similarly, the hadith of the incident of caravans has been narrated by different companions, some narrating some part, others some other part, and some others narrating other details. Just get that book, Hujjatul Aalamin fi Mojizaate Sayyidil Mursaleen, written by Muhammad Yusuf bin Ismail and Allama Zulfiqar Ali. So there is no doubt left now. The unknown patriarch in Syria, whom Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, never met or knew, neither the patriarch knew Prophet Muhammad, is saying he witnessed the animal tied near the gate. So all these incidents, facts and history are tight slaps to those who say that winged horse, white animal or Burraq is a fairy tale. Now just see how illiterate deceiver apostate is about Islam.
And Muhammad attempted to prove that the story is true by describing how the places looked that he saw on his journey. And he promised to show them a miracle, the splitting of the moon, and I will also come to that at another point. So according to hadith, Muhammad actually tried to prove that this happened.
He said, after Miraj, Prophet showed the miracle of splitting of the moon. While splitting of moon took place 6 years earlier than the incident of the night journey. Now look here again.
It's not very surprising, since Muslims and Muhammad had big Zoroastrian influence in their scripture, and people were quite familiar with Zoroastrianism. Muhammad had also a very close former Zoroastrian Persian advisor, Salman the Persian. Weirdly, Zoroastrian prayers are also very similar to Muslim prayers.
He says that Salman Farsi, may Allah be pleased with him, who was a Zoroastrian earlier, must have told Prophet stories from his religion, and based on that Prophet must have made a fake announcement, na'udzubillah. This deceiver illiterate man does not even know that Salman Farsi first met Prophet in Medina in about November 622 AD, while incident of Miraj took place 2 years earlier in Mecca, before Prophet had even migrated to Medina, and until then none of them knew each other. Now there are some others who spread confusion that Masjid al-Aqsa was not built when Prophet went on night journey, and spread doubts about the Prophet's heart being removed and washed by the Zamzam. Do not be deluded by their lies. We will soon expose those lies too. Just have patience. Stay close to Islam and truth. The liars will be exposed soon. Subscribe to our channel to see them getting exposed.